Right.
Mugs away.
Question one. Battle of the Mercy. Here we go. Question 9-2, it says. Right. Who is Tyson Fury due to fight on the 9th of June in Manchester? We were just talking about him earlier, weren't we? Not his opponent, but Tyson Fury we were talking about. Who's he due to fight?
Can this be passed over if he gets it wrong?
Yeah, I'll give you half a point.
Sorry.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Say that again.
Surrey.
That's a city.
It is one of those where you don't want to watch schoolboy football.
I see it this morning, you know.
I'm going to take an educated guess with it. I can't remember his name. I think it's Effa Efferson.
Nah.
Why?
What is it?
It's sort of like my guess.
It is Seferi.
Oh, come on! You've got to give me that. It was sort of like
he's
that,
half and half. Surrey and Seferi.
He said Surrey. And what did you say?
Efferson, I said.
You said Man City's goalie, Efferson or something.
And I said, where he's from.
Roundabout, we kind of know what we're on about.
Between us there, we got that.
Apparently, that's how you pronounce it.
Right. What venue, Paul?
Or was it me?
Could be replacing Las Vegas as the prime destination for boxing in the United States, according to reports this week.
Floral Pavilion.
Yeah.
No, hang on.
That's a joke.
Hey, guys. Come on.
Can you ask me again? I'm sorry.
Yeah, what venue could be taken over from Vegas as the prime destination for boxing in the United States?
The O2.
How can the O2 be in the United States?
It sounds a confusion.
So, I don't even know.
Well,
I can't even give you a
chance. Where do they do a lot of fighting in America? Away
Mandalay Bay.
Absolutely no idea.
What was the question again?
The Mandalay Bay is in Vegas, so it couldn't be that one, could it?
Oh, no. Okay.
The casino?
No.
Oh,
casino?
GMA.
It's the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. New York.
Oh, yeah.
So,
I remember.
So you both
wrong. We read the book.
Right.
It's in boxing's in the UK now, anyway.
Mystery voice time, Masher. Who is this voice?
It's ridiculous. It's dated. And your jacket doesn't work either.
Tom Hanks.
Stay quiet, Paul.
Can you play that again?
No, yes.
You're not allowed to do that.
It's ridiculous. It's dated. And your jacket doesn't work either.
Can I have it?
My man. Was the siren cow.
Oh, yeah! Yes!
Well, how on earth did he mastermind that?
Carly, mate, love Carly.
At last.
He said it wrong. He said it was Simon Cowley. Simon Cowley. Who is he?
That's his little pet name for him.
Okay.
My mate Cowley.
Well, yeah.
Okay.
Kecks up your chest.
Chance to equalise, Paul. Chance to equalise. Who's this voice?
So I'd pit him against Kevin. We're sort of struggling with Mark.
Rossi La.
Sick. What? Hang on a second.
You better.
Very well known voice.
Oh, right. Okay.
Extremely well known voice. Have a listen again.
So I'd pit him against Kevin. We're sort of struggling with Mark.
No more clues. I've got an idea. I'll get half a point for this. Put the timer on, the countdown. Oh, come on,
final
mate.
Go.
So I'd pit him against Kevin. We're sort of struggling with Mark.
Come on, mate. I'll give you the clue.
What? I'll
give you the clue. I waited to count his hand. I'll give you the clue. Hey, he's a singer.
Oh. He is.
Ollie Mays.
No, oh, Gary Barlow.
That's not...
What did you say?
Gary Barlow.
Absolutely no idea.
Who is it?
Robbie Williams. I nearly said Robbie.
Really?
Robbie Williams.
That's Robbie Williams.
He was in Take That With
Me. Yeah,
he was
close, really. Yeah, he's in his band.
That was Robbie Williams.
Has he had a stroke?
Right, still 1-0, Masher.
Yes.
Question 3. True or false? Most sharks have a lifespan of 50 to 60 years. Is that true or false?
Most
sharks have a lifespan. Well, you can't. Some might live, 65 years. I don't know.
So that's just made up answer then, isn't it?
We're taking an average. Most sharks have a lifespan of 50 to 60 years. Is that true or false?
50 to 60 years, that's a long time.
Only depending on if they take BCAs, protein, vitamin C.
Fish. Most sharks. Oh, that's a tough one, that.
Most sharks. I mean, do they smoke?
Shh.
Come on, we only need a true or false.
I know, yeah. Just take a guess. Leopard dead, come on.
I'll go two. Someone's telling me false.
Absolutely no idea.
My man.
Someone's telling me false.
It is false. They live between 20 to 30 years.
Hey, someone was telling them false. It was the only other answer you could have given.
So he said true. Yeah, 20 to 30 years, apparently. Gutted. Right, true or false, Paul? Gutted. Most fish can swim backwards. True or false?
Oh.
That doesn't make it any easier, does it?
Oh, my God. Fish.
And when you say fish, you're talking about octopuses and stuff like that, because they're fish.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, they are.
How?
Because there's fish, aren't they, Al?
No, mammals, aren't they?
Mammals.
I'll say two.
I got it wrong.
Why? What is going through his head? Yeah.
I've seen Finding Nemo, and I can assure you now, he swam backwards. He only had a little fin.
Yeah, he done the moonwalk.
A circular backwards motion.
He done a fin walk.
In a cartoon.
Hey.
Fantastic.
What can swim backwards?
False.
So swimming?
That's what it
fish
says on my
swim backwards?
No. Right.
No, no, no.
Masher, you're still 1-0 up. In inches, how big is the diameter of a basketball hoop? The one they have to throw ball into. So in inches. You've just got to guess, haven't you?
What are you measuring?
I'm pretending that.
You've just got to have a guess.
I've done a few slam dunks in my past.
That's the inches max. What are you doing? What are you doing?
Well, we need an answer right on the back of this.
15.
Oh, dear me. 32.
Don't tell me.
I tell you what, you weren't far out.
You got to give me a word in at least an inch or two.
No. Why is it?
18.
18 is correct. Second answer.
I was close to that. Fair play.
Oh, come on.
Fair play.
Paul, what number lies between 9 and 5 on a British dart board? You must have one of these in your pub. Oh. What number is between 9 and 5 on a dart board? So
four.
Stand up and pretend you're throwing a dart and see.
Right, hang on, let me stand up.
And just visualise the dart board.
Put the timer on, Al.
Go on. Visualise that dart board.
You only get 3 darts.
Right.
You only get 3 darts.
I visualised it.
Yeah.
I saw it. And I think it's 11.
Why?
I don't know why.
Yes.
I don't even know what a dart is.
Six.
You were so close, it's 12.
Oh!
Oh, you are.
Oh, no way.
Oh, we're both close.
Right, Smashy, you're still 1-0 up. This can win it for you.
Oh, which, they get excited.
Which Australian pop star and actress celebrated her 50th birthday on Monday? Australian pop star and actress. She was 50 on Monday.
She done Greece.
Don't listen to him.
Oh, Sandy, baby.
Oh,
I see you.
You remind me of Carrie.
I was trying to put him off.
Can you give me the answer?
That was Olivia Newton-John.
Yeah, I know. I was trying to put him off.
I just thought of Sandy singing Carrie Minogue.
No, that was John Travolta.
You
trying
to put me off and give me the answer?
Yes. So back to square one now.
Stoop dog.
Let's just see if you get a point anyway. What's the name of the character played by actress Sean Gibson in Car Share? That program with Peter Kay. What's the name of the character? You're not seeing
Johnny Walters.
Go ahead.
What's the name of the character that she plays in Car Share? Sean Gibson's the actress. She sits in the car alongside Peter Kay.
The passenger.
It is one of those where you don't want to watch schoolboy football.
Shotgun.
I am.
George Ezra.
I have never ever saw Car Share. I need to get out more often. You know, all I do is work.
It's on the telly, Dad.
Yeah. I need to bring me telly outside.
You need to stay in more.
Absolutely fantastic.
I can't believe that. Do you know what?
So there you go. Masher, you've done it again.
So what is it now, mate? Have a heart of gold.
You know, there's no other Australian singer actress that anybody knows, don't you? You've done it again, haven't you?
Olivia Newton-John.
I didn't know she was an actor.
He doesn't know Olivia Newton-John is. He didn't even know who John Travolta was.
I'd like to ask you back to stay.
Carry on, lads.
I want you in my arms just one more time.
Fantastic. Well done, Masher.
What is it now? It's 10-2. 10-2 to me.
10-2.
Before we go, can I just mention, don't forget me and Kev. Can I just mention, we've got a charity fight coming up on the 28th of July with me and Kev's Cabs. Make sure you're all there.
This the day after.
Fight. Yeah, for Chasing the Stigma, Melton.
Was that a Saturday or Sunday?
It's on the weekend.
Jazzy Dickens boxes on the 27th of July.
He's a Friday, we're a Saturday, yeah. 28th of July. Saturday. Charity fight. I'm fighting.
Where at?
It's in Club Fusion in town, Fleet Street, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, in there, so get yourselves there, boys. Decent, I think Rossi's coming, actually. Rossi's going to turn up.
Great stuff.
Rossi's going to referee.
Don't you fancy fighting Rossi for charity?
Oh, yeah, yeah,
come and fight him on the show. Rossi, you're getting called out here, mate. Live on air.
He's gone. He's disappeared from the studio next to us.
Well, he's gone. He was only messing.